A few weeks back, I upgraded from this HP EliteBook to a 13-inch MacBook Pro, and I want to put my old laptop into good use. So in this video, I turned my old laptop into a usable Chromebook, and you might want to do as well. If you're new to this channel, my name is Sankyu and I make videos revolving around tech, so do consider subscribing. Now you may have this question on your mind, why do you want to run Chrome OS on an old laptop? There are two reasons to it. The first one is that I want a laptop in which I can manage all my light tasks, such as browsing, scripting, and watching YouTube videos, just like how you would use an iPad, except that this is not a glorified tablet. And the second reason is that Windows is pretty buggy on this laptop. Now I can do all tasks I listed above in Windows and do even more like gaming, but then I would be always stuck with random bugs, crashes and many more. The thing is, for what I do with this laptop, I don't need Windows or even Linux, so that's where Chrome OS comes in. And also as a side benefit, you can run Android apps on Chrome OS if that's something you're interested in. But anyway, let's get right into the minimum requirements for this to work, and they are pretty meager. You need a laptop with at least 2 GB of RAM and around 15 to 20 gigs of space. Well, pretty much any laptop from the last 15 years can satisfy these requirements. Even your old Dell Latitude can, or your ThinkPad. So now that I've talked about the minimum requirements, let's talk about the laptop I have. So it has a 1.4 GHz 4th generation Core i5-4210U processor with a dedicated AMD GPU. I mean, the graphics card is just a HD 8750M, you can't do a lot with that anyway. A 500 GB hard drive. Yes, a hard drive. And finally, 8 GB of DDR3 memory. Pretty limited for today's standards, especially the hard drive, which is gonna hold back us a lot. Okay, now let's get to the part where you get to replicate this with your laptop. Now here's the small story of how this is possible. This is possible due to Neverware, a company that maintains Chromium versions of Chrome OS for home and business use. It is also certified by Google if you're concerned about it. Anyways, it's called Cloud Ready and there are two ways to install it. The first one is where you download the zip file from Neverware and flash it with Chrome recovery tool. And the another one is with Neverware's simplified USB installer tool, and I would be demonstrating both, so stick along if you want to go for either option. So let's replicate the easy way, doing it with Neverware's simple software. Now open the link in the description to see what I'm seeing, and this only works on Windows, so if you are on macOS or Linux, take a look at the next step. Alright, so all we have to do is download the software and run it, and when we do, we get a prompt to plug in a USB, then after a few minutes, depending on your internet speed and USB speed, it would be done. It took roughly 20 minutes for me to finish the entire thing, including downloading the file and flashing it to my USB. And my USB was a USB 3 drive, so it was pretty fast. Alright then, if you're done with this, go ahead with the part where we install. Now for the ones who are running other operating systems such as Linux and macOS, so head over to the link where we can download the image file for Cloud Ready, and it's a 1.1 gig file, so give it a few minutes. So after it's done, open Chrome, and if you haven't installed Chrome already, do it. I'm assuming many people would be using Chrome. Okay, now in Chrome, install an extension called Chromebook Recovery Utility, and after it's done, open it and it would give you an option to get started, but then don't do that. But instead, click the gear icon and select Use Local Image. Select the downloaded file and plug in your USB. Now select your drive and give it a few minutes. And after it's done, you have successfully made a USB installer for Chrome OS. Now let's get to the easy part of installing it, and all it takes is plugging it into your laptop and selecting the appropriate key for your specific laptop. Now here are the key combinations for the most popular brands. After you've done that, select your drive from the list and give it a minute or so to boot into Chrome OS, and now it would ask you to connect to a Wi-Fi network. So do that and sign in with your Google account after that. Now here is where you can test out how good Chrome OS is and how it would run on your laptop. Or if you're ready, you can go ahead with installing it by clicking here. This would take a while and wipe your data, so make sure to take a backup. Give the installer a while and you would be done. So continue with the setup process and you're done. So that's it. We have successfully turned my old laptop into a usable Chromebook, and it's very fast and responsive compared to Windows. Drop a like and comment down your issues and experience with Chrome OS. Thanks for watching. This is Sankyu. Make sure to subscribe for some tech videos, and I'm signing off now. Peace.